lot has been talked about research, but let me remind you, my dear friends, that an audit of the best journals in the world, the so-called best journals, quote-unquote, has shown that 97% of the research data that is published there is not worth the paper on which it is written. Because what is research? Repetitional research. This is what we do. We repeat what others have done. That's called repetitive research, which is of no consequence at all. Because it is Karl Popper, a great thinker, a professor of science philosophy in the London School of Economics in the 50s, wrote one very important sentence. In Hindi, it is called Kahavat. He said, knowledge advances not by repeating known things, but by refuting false dogmas. It's only then that the knowledge goes forwards. And none of our research, not even one paper in the Indian journals that I know of, has taken knowledge forwards in any field, especially in medicine. I'll give you an example. 127 AD, Galen wrote that the liver pumps blood. For 1500 years, remember that? 1500 years, every professor of medicine, every researcher, everybody, every journal wrote that liver pumps blood. It was only in 1628, a thinking, ordinary, practicing doctor in London, who was not very busy, but he was curious about the world, seeing a small fire hydrant, thought that the blood comes and goes from the heart. So he wrote De Motu Cordis in 1628. William Harvey was his name. And for writing that, he was to be killed. Because if you oppose the great people in those days, you were either killed, poisoned, or sent into the mental hospital as a madman. So Harvey was to be killed. So some of his friends said, run for your life. So he ran out at darkness and walked up to Calais and took the boat, went to France, and was hiding in Germany for one full year. When the king called him back and said, look, your ideas are accepted, come back. Those days, you don't get an honorary degree or a PhD from the governor. You get the king's accepting it. That's then it becomes what is called thesis. Thesis is the pedestal on which the theory is kept. Hypothesis is something which cannot be kept up, so it is kept down under there. So the hypothesis becomes a thesis when the king accepts it. So the king accepted that, and William Harvey's De Motu Cordis, heart pumps blood. It took 1500 years in any area. Ptolemy in the 2nd century said sun goes around the earth, and for 5 centuries every scientist said sun goes around the earth. It was only Copernicus in the 7th century who came and said, no, earth goes around the sun. So it took 500 years for knowledge to go forwards. So I want you youngsters who have now got, you know, really charged with all your enthusiasm to do research which refutes false dogmas in medicine, of which there are plenty. Actually, medicine is full of false dogmas. Demolish them one by one. Then people will be happy. Actually, it was in the year 2002, I was invited for a convocation address in the White Memorial Center of the University of California in Los Angeles, where I introduced a concept called medical humanism. What we need is humanism. Anything that you do should have some comfort for the other human being. That's called the real art of medicine. You know what art is? Art is making another man's day. Art of medicine is making somebody comfortable, and that's the real humanism of medicine. So whatever is your degree, whatever is your encomiums, whatever are your achievements, see that the suffering humanity which needs your help gets what it wants. You don't know when you're well what you want. When you're ill, you want your doctor to be a god. You want your doctor to be the best human being that you have. And then if you are ill, you know you want a good doctor. But when someone else is ill, you have to be a good doctor if you really want to reciprocate that feeling. That's called medical humanism, a word which Comte in France introduced for business humanism. Humanism in business, humanism in medicine, humanism in science. Today what has happened is science has also lost its character. Science is actually inquiry. But today science has become a business. Science has become a religion. And science is so dogmatic, more dogmatic than religion. And today science has got so many myths which have to be demolished. Now let me say what research you have to do. Find out you have a problem. You know, every day you have a problem on the bedside. If you have a problem on the bedside, try to go as far away from the bed as you can to get an answer. That is called true research. And this is the only way we can take knowledge forwards in this area. One of the biggest stumbling blocks in medicine is dominance of one system over all other systems in treatment. That's the Western medical system. And why the Western medical system is believed to be the best? Because we were brought up in that education school. In school, we were told Western education is the best. We were told, and nobody talks about Indian education. It's only now, with Narendra Modi becoming the Prime Minister of the country, some people have started thinking about Indian education. Formerly, if you talk about Indian education, they say you are either a villager or you are uneducated. But truly, it's the West that wants Indian education today. Because Western education has no meaning at all. And Western education makes everybody same robot. Actually, no two human beings are alike. But the school wants you to be alike. And this is where our educational system has gone wrong. So unless we reform our school system, our research will not change also. So there's no use preaching to you at this stage. I should go and tell the primary school teachers what the child must be taught to think, T-H-I-N-K. Actually, you'll be surprised. I started Leave to Think, LTC, Leave to Think Club, when I became the dean of the medical school. The membership is for a person with a curious idea, he becomes a member. And then, if he has a curious idea, we give him all the support to do research. And you will be surprised, we got so many good things about it. One boy came up with an idea saying that, sir, why do mosquitoes go around your nose and your face only? Why don't they go around your leg? I said, why? Because they like carbon dioxide. And I said, so what? I said, sir, I'll get a small little device which generates carbon dioxide. Keep it in the room so it attracts all the mosquitoes and they can be killed, so that the man or the woman can sleep comfortably without mosquito bite. Because today we have all chemicals, you know. You see in the television chemicals. These will kill. Somebody said, oh, macharon ka yamaraj hai. Then I told that man, oh, manushon ka bhai yamaraj hoga, because it's the same biological cell that the man has also got. So they are as bad. But this is a great idea. This carbon dioxide is a great idea. Then he also said, sir, this neem oil repels mosquitoes. I said, how do you know? Let's do some research. So we had rats, two sets of rats. Shaved them clean and put them in the cages with a lot of mosquitoes. One of them we smeared with neem oil, and you would be surprised, there's not a single mosquito bite on the neem oil mosquitoes. So these ideas come when you only allow people to think. If you don't allow them to think and think like anything else and what is in the book, vomit it out and mug it up and then get the first rank. Then we say, oh, he's a great boy, he's first rank, he's second rank, he's gold medalist, he's this, he's that. Congratulations. But then, it's only mediocrity. You are competing with others. Real excellence comes when you compete with yourself. You must try to be better tomorrow than what you are today. That's called excellence. Mediocrity is competing with others. I am first in the class. If you are first in your class, you may be the last in the whole country. So it doesn't mean anything. It's only mediocrity. So we are only encouraging mediocrity in this country now. Now that's not good. Actually, you know, you'll be surprised. When I congratulate all the gold medalists here, I congratulate more those who did not get the gold medalist. Do you know why? It is they who made you get the gold medal. You are only comparing with them. So you got a gold medal because someone else didn't get the gold medal. And someone else was not as good as you are.